A student debt jumps at North Carolina schools, and Samsung unveils its new smartphone today. Jane King live at the NASDAQ to tell us all about that. Good morning, Jane.
Hey, Melissa, good morning. Yes, North Carolina's average student debt is on the rise. That's according to LendEDU's annual student loan debt report. Now, for the class of 2017, the average debt per borrower in the state was $26,164. That's up about 3.5% from a year ago. Now, a total of 58% of graduates did have debt when they finish school. Well, New York will have the first big city cap on Uber and Lyft. The measure also comes with a minimum wage for drivers. Supporters say the ride-hailing apps have led to congestions in the city, but opponents say it was often the only option for people who live outside of the city to get a ride. It likely will drive up prices as well. Whole Foods offering curbside pickup for Prime members. The Whole Foods service will start in Sacramento and Virginia Beach, and then will expand to more cities this year. Orders of $35 and up are free if pickup is within an hour. Pickups within 30 minutes will cost $4.99. Well, Walmart can make or break a product, and now it's hurt sales of Hostess Twinkies just because it rearranged where it puts them on the shelves, and it gave the Hostess products general less promotion in the stores. The snack brand has been trying to regain its footing since filing for bankruptcy 6 years ago. And Samsung holds its Galaxy Unpacked event today. It's expected to unveil the Note 9 smartphone. Some details of the phone have already leaked, like a better camera, more storage, and better battery life. Samsung will also pour $22 billion into new technology, so things like artificial intelligence and 5G, as it searches for new products to power growth. And more men are growing full beards, goatees, or stubble. That's hurting sales at Gillette, which is owned by Procter & Gamble. P&G believes it's easier for men today to avoid a shave during the work week or on a casual weekend. And stocks did end the day flat yesterday. The China trade tensions are never very far away. There was also Disney's lower earnings, uncertainty about the future of Tesla. And today, boy, super quiet, just about 1 point higher is what we're looking at today. I mean, August is always quiet, but man, this is ridiculous. Live from the NASDAQ market site in Times Square, I'm Jane King for Fox 8 News. Melissa, back to you.
Thank you, Jane.
Thanks.